What's up? It is 8 o'clock. 03. So y'all already know what's up with me. Yeah, I'm in this bitch watching ZL. Fuck what you think. I never really watched ZL like this. It was, I see why. This much Power Rangers even when I was a kid, boy, I ain't gonna lie. I was a big ass fan. Like, I used to try to get everybody to watch that bitch with me. But, bro, I really feel like I've been watching that shit more and more these days. Fucking one of the reasons, because it's always playing on this fucking Watch Free channel, Watch Free shit on my Vizio. So, like, I can't get mad. And at first they were just doing Mighty Morphin. Now they going in order. They showing all them bitches. I don't know if they showing all them bitches. I think the latest one I saw they did was like probably Mythic Force. I think, but I'm pretty sure they went a little farther. But yeah. I just be want to catch that bitch once we hit in space. You know, that way it can go to Lost Galaxy. It can go to fucking Lightspeed Rescue and Time Force. Top four. Real shit. Not in that order. Well, no, definitely not in that order. definitely not in order. Once you hit her with the tune, she gonna be through. Da 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 da. Ba da ba ba ba. Ba da ba da ba. I don't care what's your name. It doesn't matter what's your name. Woo, call me the Rock. Woo, hit you with a ba ba ba. Motherfucking final boss, bitch. I'm definitely switching to YouTube after I fill this bowl up. Because after Zio is going to be Turbo. And Turbo is okay. Turbo is okay. And I think it's okay just because they started associating vehicles with the Power Rangers. Like actual vehicles. Like I think Mighty Morphin had like real bikes or some shit, but like actual cars, like trucks and SUVs and shit. Like, yeah. It was okay. Like I said, the best ones are In Space. Let me put them in order. The best ones are In Space, Lightspeed Rescue, Time Force, Lost Galaxy. In that order. That's the top four. If I had to say top five, I'll put Mighty Morphin in it. Real shit. You know, everybody be like, oh, that should be in the top three. That should be number one. No. But let's be honest. Let's be completely honest right now while we talking about it. Mighty Morphin only had maybe what? I was about to do it so bad. I was about to say they only had one fucking good storyline. You know, well, I'll give it two, maybe three, maybe, bruh, I'm sorry, maybe I'm not old enough, I don't know, fuck, I remember vividly, In Space, Lost Galaxy, Time Force, Lightspeed Rescue, they're my main four. Real life, what my phone in? Man, hold on. Cause, I'm trying to think. Cause, bro, I remember me having a Lost Galaxy toy. I remember having that bitch, and we was living in an apartment, so that means I was young as hell. Probably just gained consciousness. But I was fucking with In Space though. So yeah. So Lost Galaxy probably came out around like 2003. Probably, maybe two. Fuck, I gotta look that up now, man.
I opened up my phone all morning. That's the only reason I got it. Oh, wow.
fucking Lost Galaxy came out in 99. And Time Force came out in 2001. That is crazy. That is crazy. I don't know how to feel about that. That is crazy. That's real life crazy. But anyways,
go to YouTube. Bruh, I really wish I could like back the camera out a bit on this, bro. Real talk. That's why I kind of prefer doing it on Twitch. But even if I do it on Twitch from here, it's going to look like this. And no. I'm sorry. That's why I hope I find a charger for the laptop my coworker gave me. Because if I can get that back running, I can run Twitch off of here and run YouTube off the laptop. Retarded, you feel bad. Last night I decided to watch the channel preview react to X-Men 97. Y'all was with me. Stupid ass. We watch High School Musical and shit like that. I'm just going down my subscription list right now. My bad. Did I watch the ups and downs of SmackDown? I don't think I watched the ups and downs of SmackDown. I didn't watch that. I'm gonna put that on. Then we can go on after that.
With Spring Black Friday savings now at the Home Depot, you can power your spring. And only need one battery to do it all. Gaslight power. Endless possibilities. Only at the Home Depot, your power source.
Yes, I'm in my mysterious location. It isn't mysterious. I am about to go on tour with The Last Match, which is a pro wrestling rock musical, so I'm in the States for a while. So if you do live on the East Coast and you'd like to come see me be a bad guy, well, you should probably do that. But you think the thing will coalesce, which is, no, it doesn't. So let's take it, keep the cookies up, and the fabrics are down when it comes to the
post-mortem.
Anyway, going back to my start at the start of this video, Cody Rhodes did the story. And because The Rock had mugged him off on board, he actually said the line, "Who told you it was open mic night, bitch? You don't know, don't worry about it."
Man, I wish I had some juice.
Every single time.
Oh, my God. It's the reason that
I
want that
bone shredder. But it also thinks I'm right on the final boss.
I really think that all the cans are Nick Fury. And I don't like that. Because what if I decide to get another box? Because I thought like it was going to be like a scramble, like a random of the people in there. Out the box so far, I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out the box. All had Nick Fury on that bitch. Now, when I first saw the box in
when I first saw the box in the Albertsons when I all got it, I was just looking at the outside of it. I was like, oh, they got all the motherfuckers in here. I'm about to collect all the cans, you know? Bruh. Because I mainly just wanted, you know, collect all the cans in one swoop and put the box up on my wall because they got the Marvel characters on the box. Bro, if I get another motherfucking box and they got Nick Fury in it, I'm going to drink it. I'll be pissed. I might not never get a box of fucking Coke until they're through with this fucking advertising. Real talk. Unless I'm at somebody else's house and they offer me them bitches and this and you know, yeah. I'm taking it. The fuck? Not for real, bro. They're gonna be like a train car type shit, bro. Cause I'm pretty sure they pushing these bitches out like that, bro. So yeah. Let me go in somebody's house, go in somebody's house and they offer me a fucking Coke. Marvel Coke? Hey, they gonna be looking at me like Marvel Coke. The fuck is Marvel Coke? Yo, real life though. You got that Marvel Coke? That's the only Coke I need in my life right now. That Marvel Coke, not Nick Fury Coke. You know, not Marvel Nick Fury Coke, but just you know any other Marvel Coke. Easy. They're gonna be looking at me crazy. I can see that shit now. That is gonna be. Oh, that's gonna be hilarious. Hilarious.
Now I made that sound way more complicated than it actually.
Oh, let's go. But yeah, I'm gonna cook me a little bit. Bang all right, quick, because I'm hungry. You feel me? So yeah.
The post WrestleMania, smack it down. Anyway, going back to my stuff at the start of this video, Cody Rhodes did walk to the ring. And because The Rock had mugged him off on Raw, he actually said the line, "Who told you it was open mic night, bitch? You don't know, don't worry about it." But it's a big laugh every single time. It's the reason that I will like Randy Rhodes forever. Rhodes also thinks of
the fact that the two,
he has to look forward to that pay-per-view pre-live event, which is Backlash.
Oh my just God, Backlash, Becky.
Not WrestleMania Becky. Backlash. We ain't done that. Involved in one of these bouts, and given that him and Santos Escobar lost at WrestleMania, Why the fuck are they allowed to try and compete for the WWE title? As you and Randy Orton right now, he's in a triple threat match, he didn't win, but also didn't lose. You would be sat on the sidelines going, man, these voices in my head, they're telling me I should be enraged. You'd be totally correct. See, I'm being lame. Let's get it out. Otherwise, this was just super fun, although Santos is such an idiot. Because he tried to jump these two, so LA and Bob went, why don't we join forces and become Bob Lahr, which they would do. They walked Zan. But he then realized in that moment he could try and surprise Bob with the most devastating moves. They all the sports entertainment to surprise Romper. The last year was a bit like, you know, I'm more experienced than you. He kicked out. Then it all started to boil when Santos Escobar didn't die, because of course it is 2024, when everyone kind of got saved by the commercial break, when we came back from the advert. Bob and Santos were just fighting. Well, I guess they murdered LA Nice. Turned out that instead he was just going to try and do a super flex, but Bobby Lashley spied this from afar. When he did the wrestling match, and he realized, oh my gosh, there are three guys total. So you know what he did? The Tower of Doom spot. He absolutely loves the top. Even LA Knight was able to hit his elbow, because then it went totally crazy. Because the Baron Del Fantasma ran out, as did the Street Profits, and of course everybody was getting involved in the schmoz. And
oh Lord, thank you.
But he missed, just mostly because
nigga ain't washed his hands. I'm glad I ain't open that thing.
More wrestlers could learn from this, but of course it also meant he had come
to the final. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Behind him, he hit the butt horse trailer, and he got the 1, 2, 3. It is going on. And
then it happened.
Of course, it's jumped until we could all figure out what was going to happen.
It happened. Look, let me take another bomb here while it,
Yeah, that was happening. I've been watching this from the back as well. It didn't make sense. And Kevin Brant's was like, oh, hey, Brant, come here for a second. I was talking to Sal's earlier. He said last week he wasn't responsible for attacking Dragon Lee. Not that. Gamer, that's what a guilty man says. Mysterio basically ruled this as he wants to focus on the match later. Even though he is a Hall of Famer, he still has one last championship run in his veins. I tell you this, I'm sure there are a lot of people on this show. I'm going to say about the Masked Man too.
Interested.
And I tell you this, it's starting to bang. Paul Heyman got the microphone and said, well, on the half of the end of the table, we admit no excuses, pain won't bring us. But Paul also made sure to mention that Seth Rollins had been Cody's shield, like he said he was going to do. And of course, Rollins was totally obsessed with what happened back in 2014. He took his attention off the American Nightmare, and he focused on Rollins instead. After like, got themselves a little bit like it was kicking. They get me excited though, because of course without part of those scenes that they could just make me on everybody breaks versus Seth Rollins, which people have wanted for ages. Rollins lost his mind. He's like, listen, from all this, we need to talk about the fact that wins and losses have consequences. But he looked at Jimmy Uso. And they're like, Jim, you'd better run. But he didn't. He just looked confused. He was okay with this, because Solo, brother, I love you. You make me whole inside.
Jesus Christ.
And of course, Rollins is totally obsessed with what happened back in 2014. He took his attention off the American Nightmare, and he focused on the match later. Even though he is a Hall of Famer, he still has one last championship run in his veins. There's such a thing about a lot of people on this show. I'm going to say about the Masked Man too. I totally love it. Vince on the Bloodline head into the ring, so I got super. Said, well, on behalf of the head of the table, we admit it, no excuses, Cody Rhodes beat us. But now, Paul also made sure to mention that Seth Rollins had been Cody's shield, like he said he was going to do, and because Rollins is totally obsessed with what happened back in 2014, he took his attention off the American Nightmare, and he focused on Rollins instead. After they're like, Paul, kind of sounds a little bit like an excuse. They get me excited though, because of course without planning those scenes that maybe, just maybe, we are going to do Roman Reigns versus Seth Rollins, which people have wanted for ages. But Solo Sikoa lost his mind. He was like, listen, from all this, we need to talk about the fact that wins and losses have consequences. But he looked at Jimmy Uso, and they're like, Jim, you better run. But he didn't. He just looked confused. Actually, at first he was okay with this, because Solo hugged him. He was like, oh, brother, I love you. You make me whole inside. But that's it. Turned out this was a massive bruise when a hooded figure appeared from the crowd, and when he took that thing down, who was it? It was the debutante we've been waiting for. Tama Tonga is not only in WWE, he's joined the flipping Bloodline. At least you absolutely whipped Jim's ass. And I was like, man, I totally feel your pain, Uso. You've been a long-term watcher of What Culture Wrestling. A few years ago, don't tell her Tonga tried to kill me. So now I've got PTSD. Tonga didn't know Jimmy up as well, so Solo could just spike him over and over again.
Ow,
like he was a fat party. No, this is not what the tribal chief wants. We spent the car right over to him. He thought he was about to be killed too.
Oh, thank you.
No, Solo dragged him to the middle of the ring. Everybody did the one finger thing at the gym. So the front knows what's happening. So when Tommy lost it, he got a chair. He put it over Jimmy Uso's head before he put him in the turnbuckle as he ran at him and pulverized him with his ass. As he basically said to Paul Heyman, which was under the orders of the tribal chief. Yeah, my great stuff too. I was like, oh my gosh, maybe the Rock has actually taken over for the fight. This was such a great angle though, because I remember the old Bloodline 2.0. It was a couple of ties back into 1998. Did you remember what happened there? Shawn Michaels lost the match, he went away. Triple H took over to Generation X and made it even better. And I think that's what we could do here. Oh, look. They're at about 10 seconds, so come on.
I turned the volume up just so I can listen to the nigga talk about this shit. Hold on, I'm tripping.
But it was bad!
Oh, brother, I love you. You make me whole inside. But that's it. Turned out this was a massive ruse. When a hooded figure appeared from the crowd, and when he took that thing down, who was it? It was the debutante we've been waiting for. Tama Tonga is not only in WWE, he joined the flipping club line. At least you were absolutely what Jim's at. I'm sorry, man. I totally feel your pain, Uso. You've been a long-term watcher of What Culture Wrestling. A few years ago, Tama Tonga tried to kill me, so now I've got the PTSD. Tonga then held Jimmy up as well, so Solo could just spike him over and over again, like he was a frat party. The whole time, Paul was like, no, this is not what the tribal chief wants. Which when Sakala went over to Heyman, he thought he was about to be killed too, but no. Solo dragged him to the middle of the ring, and everybody did the one finger thing of the jig. So the flood knows what's happening. Simon then totally lost it, because he got a chair. He put it over Jimmy Uso's head before he put him in the turnbuckle as he ran at him and pulverized him with his ass. As he basically said to Paul Heyman, you know what? This was under the orders of the tribal chief. Do you know what my brain started to do? I was like, oh my gosh, maybe the Rock has actually taken over from afar. This was such a great angle though, because not only did it launch Bloodline 2.0, it also kind of ties back into 1998. Could you remember what happened there? Shawn Michaels lost the match, he went away. Triple H took over to Generation X and made it even better. And I think that's what we could do here. There are like 10 seconds, so Kawa feels like a killer again. Who also do remember the teams that maybe the final boss is in control? Yes, this was total fire. Let's get it up. When Cameron Grimes put Seth back on SmackDown. What the fuck? But he was facing Bron Breakker too, so you knew what was going to happen here.
What the fuck?
In about 3 minutes, Bron just went pew, 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 pew. Went 100 miles an hour. He smashed this guy's around. Just get him.
The hardest, like, hit the best spin you've ever seen.
And beat him for the 1-2-3. And beat him isn't even a word. And the Bron Breakker looks absolutely amazing during all of this. And he is going to go all the way. And I would always take a match like this, so it is going to get up. But I feel really sorry for Cameron Grimes. He was all cooked up in NXT, and he was ready to go. And now if we do anything with him, we're going to have to hit reset. And that just makes me feel upset at my twitchy toes. It's a strange thing for an adult to say. So once again, going back to being a lame Larry, that's got to get the ring before she was able to talk to us. We were having a chat with AJ Styles. And
God.
He too said,
like,
oh, Lord, I'm
going to
win this triple threat match later. Then I will get my revenge.
I don't understand
your
twin.
That's exactly
understand.
What we were going to do. Hey, oh, look, basically, someone who did win a WrestleMania though was Bayley. She came out here with her brand new championship.
What you don't
this
get,
crowd
bitch.
Went absolutely crazy.
What
she saw her tears in her eyes,
bitch.
Not really, but it was emotional. And she was like, man, I just want to thank you for supporting me for the last 11 years. And I was like, Bayley, I will support you until the end.
I was always there for you.
I just really enjoy wrestlers being idiots.
Try Old Spice Total Body. Try to get some freshness that hits the toes.
Okay.
hit them with it.
What I see.
It got kind of strange, though, because Bayley was like, actually, I've already got a contender in mind. When she invited Naomi to the ring, and Naomi did indeed walk to the squared circle. So what was she doing? Just acting backstage, going, I hope somebody says my name.
I hope somebody
says my name. I'm an idiot. And to be fair, though, this actually did tie in, because Tiffany just laughed this off, went, she doesn't deserve nothing, because I beat her on SmackDown a couple of months ago. I was like, she did. Ties in. Naomi made this one true as well, so said they could sell this right now, and I will never get mad at this. I like the fact I have been rewarded for being a nerd and watching all the wrestling shows. It kind of does tie it to new WWE. Give it an app. We were going to get this match too. Before that, we were going backstage with Bloodline 2.0. I just realized I forgot to tell you earlier. At the end of that first segment, Paul Heyman had his phone. He said, call Roman Reigns. Do you know what Solo did? He threw that phone on the floor and he broke it. I don't think he likes the Tribal Chief anymore. I don't think Tamatonga is a big fan of him either, because he got in Paul's face and said, I did this under the orders of the Tribal Chief. So once again, we are just planting the seeds. Who the hell is the Tribal Chief now? Maybe it's me. Well, I wouldn't have ordered this. I would have just said we should sit down for tea and crumpets. So I made sure to back up Tama here as Paul Heyman just sold terror within his face. I'm just going to tell you this. It is good stuff. This is when we get into Naomi versus Tiffany Stratton. Naomi straight away was going after Tiffany's shoulder, and she's what, maybe with doing it ringside, she's going, yeah, go Naomi, go. But that's totally unfair. And by Stratton, got mad, so she went after Naomi's shoulder and threw them into the ring post. And once again, Bayley sold this like it was an attempted murder. And I want to ring Nick Aldis. You better talk to your champion. She's not playing fair. You might as well break kind of same day, only because when we did come back from that, she hit this awesome crossbody and she followed up with a splash. This is what we brought into the 1-2 move. Tiffany then did the same because she thought she could win this with the most devastating move in all of sports entertainment, but as always, that didn't work. When she hit this amazing Alabama slam, in many ways, that should be a finish. Instead, though, she did go for the prettiest moonsault ever, which is her proper ending move. But this time, she totally missed, so what did Naomi do? She had a variation of the most devastating moves in all the sports entertainment surprise roll up. And of course, it worked here. 1-2-3. So I really did enjoy this, and I am going to give it up, mostly because Bayley versus Naomi is a match I didn't realize they did need a pay per view preview live event until now. But once again, we are just going to do a bit more negative Nancy. Because this was essentially a geese title shot. But in this situation, it was the champions who made them not just had them out like candy. I don't think Naomi has actually won a singles match on TV. So I don't mean to give that a down, but look, that's just me being a sensitive Sally and trying to bring parity to the force. But in terms of my entertainment, I was entertained. I don't think that made any sense. We then just got the best video for Grayson Waller and Austin Theory, who are the brand new tag team champions. I could love that team anymore. We cut to Nick Aldis. He was talking to the new Catch Republic on the street prop and said, oh, Lonely Boys, calm down. I will find you some challengers, and maybe one of you will. Good challenge for the tag team titles. I don't think either of them should win. Really, kind of need some more teams on SmackDown. Everyone's kind of had a shot. Also, there's all Logan Paul from his house saying, oh, I was responsible for all this WrestleMania success. And look, I am still the US champion. When we saw Chelsea Green and Piper Niven go to Nick Aldis, and clearly Chelsea hasn't learned from Laura at all, because he was like, I want to face somebody random. Nikki was like, well, why don't you go to the ring, and I'll see what I can do. And once again, if you did watch Monday Night Show, I'm sure you could figure this out, because these two jabrones stood in the ring. And who were their opponents? It was Jade Cargill again. This time, she was backed up by Bianca Belair. I was like, listen, I would bet my life on this. They are never going to lose. Chelsea got wrecked straight away as well, so she basically tagged out to Piper Niven, although she didn't fare much better. Well, I suppose at one point, she kind of did pull on Bianca's hair a little bit. Look at me. How the hell can I empathize with that? Gracie Cargill got the tag and Chelsea just happened to be in the ring. So once again, she just wrecked her with the jaded and she got the 1-2-3. And I actually think we could keep these two together for a long time. But it's also a team I actually want to see break up eventually. Because who doesn't want to see Bianca Belair versus Jade Cargill? And if you are one of the individuals that are like, oh, Jade Cargill needs to do a 15-minute match, even though her squashing people is more than fine. Do you know who is a good soldier to pull it out of her? Bianca Belair. So I just think all of this works, and look, I get excited about these two together, which once again is meant to be the point of professional wrestling. Not meant to sit there going, I'm really bored. I wasn't. That is the same with Kevin Owens, who never bores me. And most weeks he just actually wins the night. as rated X. He's going to buy a Saxon at all these new WWE production things, when, of course, he used the brand new camera cut to just walk straight to the ring for his triple threat match. It was a talk about the fact that him and Rey Mysterio have sons that are taller than him, but is his son isn't an asshole, because of course he hates Dominic. Also pretty sure that KO knocked a CM Punk shirt onto the floor here. Once again, if you know, you know. If we ever get to that feud and we go proper inside a baseball with it, my word, things will never be the same again. This of course did bring us to our main event though, which was Kevin Owens versus Rey Mysterio versus AJ Styles. I've said 1,000 times, you could do this match 392 occasions, and it'd always be brilliant. They all went at it before KO's end of grab Styles and throw it to Barry Barricade, but that's when Rey realized, oh my gosh, I have an opening now, and he smashed Kevin Owens, so as you go, I go, everyone goes, where's your man? This went triple threat crazy, because everybody was going for their maneuvers. When AJ Styles cut off the 619, this
ring made me jump,
and if I keep jumping so mad about this, it's not my back room. Owens then joined in because he hit this ridiculous super kick onto Rey Mysterio, who's basically murdered him. When he saw AJ, he gave him a super kick. This is when I started to worry because Kevin was getting way too much offense here.
Like, when you get with it, you gotta do it good.
I was then proven even more correct because Owens aimed to German suplex both these guys like he was in the sauerkraut. And even when Rey went for the 619 with him, Kevin went and he hit the stunner. That was brilliant. So then stopped Kevin from doing a swanton bomb, and I promise you, this is what happened. Owens was lying on the floor, so AJ Styles and Rey Mysterio climbed to the top of Tina the Turnbuckle when AJ got Rey in the Styles clash position, where he hit an avalanche-style clash onto Kevin Owens, who was on the floor, and in the same movement, he pinned Rey Mysterio for the 1-2-3. And I'm covering my eyes, because that was so damn well done, I'm never going to see anything better. It also means that next week, AJ will also probably defeat LA Knight, but I'm totally cool with this, because it means I'm back at Backlash, which is going down in France. We can do Cody Rhodes versus AJ Styles, and they have a little bit of history too. And if you are looking challenges to step up to the plate for the first time, I tell you this, Styles was a fantastic choice. They will have such a good match. I didn't expect this, but I'm damn sure giving it now. So all in all, I thought this was a really good SmackDown. My favorite thing about it was that it just planted seeds, and I cannot wait for the Bloodline 2.0. I don't want to spoil it for you, but WWE may have signed some other Samoans recently. I think this thing is only going to grow. And of course, please do like the video, share the video, and subscribe. Check the video on the screen. Stops and downs for AEW Dynamite, where, yes, we're talking about that CM Punk footage. Otherwise, make sure you let your comments know in the comments.
I don't give a fuck about that CM Punk footage. All I saw was a CM, saw a nigga test somebody else gangster, and yay, it went away. It went away. I just say that. The fuck? I really haven't been watching no Deadpool shit, like, at all. Well, no, yeah, not right now. So, go to him. Hit on with it.
Who just picked up Buffalo Wild Wings, go? The Hankster!
Hey!
What?
Jimmy already got beat up, go.
Yeah, Jimmy already got beat up, go.
It'll be minutes. I ain't got no fucking grits, bitch.
Okay, Jimmy already got beat up, go delivered. But did he get 6 free wings?
Yeah.
No!
Cypher was a lifesaver. It really was.
When we first talked about the business, I could tell. It's more than just a new direction for you.
Yeah, it's a full-time passion now.
Oh, some people woke up to some news and had them celebrating all day. Some people out there today is the very special day. Some people say, I'll probably go.
It comes for everyone.
It comes for everyone, but not soon enough. And also, let me just say this, man. I should have known something was up. You know, today is technically my day out. I have things I want to do, but a certain O.J. Simpson said the hell you do.
A certain O.J. Simpson
said, you know, your plans are my plans today, because on your day off, I'm just going to decide to. I don't know.
If every time I decide to like take a day off, somebody has to always agree on my time by dying.
Selfish.
It's selfish, man. You know what I mean? An asshole to the very end.
He was good at it.
Yeah, give him that. The man is killing my time.
All right.
Just a true villain to the end.
It ain't cartoons, it's someone who acts like a cartoon.
Oh, no, damn, boy, I had things I wanted to do. I said, you know what? He died inside. I don't mind talking about it. I'm on. I get carpets today. I ran all around his house. I had sparklers in my hands and everything. Like many people out there, I am not a fan of O.J. Simpson. At one time I was, and that's what we're going to talk about. O.J. Simpson, dead at 76, and some people saying couldn't have happened to a nicer guy. Prostate cancer is what this man died from. And look, if the justice system couldn't get him, then you know, let life be the justice.
His asshole got him.
Yes. Hey, how appropriate.
Yeah.
He was an asshole, and how ironic that his asshole killed him.
Yeah, beautiful.
It's like poetry, right? It really is. It really is. I like it. Write that thing. Asshole to asshole.
OJ Simpson.
If I was an asshole. Yes. This is how I die.
This by my asshole.
Yeah. Yeah, this man right here. I'm like everybody else out there, the majority of people. I'm not a big fan of O.J. Simpson, but at one time in my life, I'm old enough to have lived that moment where O.J. was a hero.
Yeah, I miss that. He was always, like, kind of just a jerk, but, like, you know, growing up watching movies, there were times where it's like, he kind of was like a Mel Gibson person, where it's like, let me ignore that stuff while I'm watching this, but fuck this guy.
Well, yeah, you know, it's like
I don't know if they want me to pop this bitch. What is that? Yeah, I don't know. They want me to pop this bitch or what?
The pre-murder OJ. And then you go to that time where you know you had the murder.
I had a little baby one on my shit, boy. When I scraped that bitch, boy, I was
damn near crying.
It's funny because a lot of people saw this coming, and some people didn't. I didn't know that the man was already kind of frail and was already walking around. You know, using a cane. Not the OJ that we've seen, because, I mean, listen, say what you will. Again, I don't like OJ. Everybody knows OJ was on trial for the murder of Nicole Brown Simpson Ron Goldman.
Oh, yeah, there were other people.
Yeah, so a lot of people forget that he killed two people. Not just Nicole Brown Simpson, but he killed Ron Goldman.
He's a 2-for-1 special, that guy.
Yeah.
2-for-1 special, that guy.
I don't know, there's some love triangle going on, jealousy involved. I mean, this man was a true crime story. He went in and killed both of them in what they say was a fit of jealousy and was acquitted for it. So, say what you will about O.J. Simpson. I mean, a lot of people hated this, but, you know, he looked into his 60s and 70s. You know, he looked amazing for his age, which pissed a lot of people off. They're like, why does this guy deserve all of this? Why does this guy deserve to like be healthy? Why does this guy deserve to actually, you know, be blessed still with his looks? And he gets to keep his money, he gets to retire and sit back. And I know this man was, I know he was getting off time with women. I know that this guy was enjoying life. I know he still had money that he was resting on. You know, that he retired in Vegas.
Yeah, I was going to say, I thought he lived in Vegas, yeah. So you know that he was up to no good.
Yeah. Now, there was a civil case against him where families, they came in and they had a, it's, they couldn't get him on murder. So, you know, they just, they got him when they tried to get people, they can't get him with murder. They attacked him back then. And so they were supposed to receive some money, some damage.
You see, that burn I got on my scene, that's a different burn.
He's supposed to hold families some money, but...
That's a Freon burn.
I don't even know if he really paid anything.
So just let me put it like this. Imagine getting burnt. And you know, burnt is like dealing with like fire most of the time. Imagine getting burnt by the coldest shit ever. It may not feel like it, but just imagine getting burnt by the coldest shit ever.
You've earned this, so hold it up high.
It's crazy.
Because it's the things you meant.
It's fucking crazy. That's why I'm jumping out of popping that bitch unless it happened in my sleep accidentally. Ooh, so this ain't no grill burnt. This ain't no frying pan burnt. That's kind of different. Kind of. It seemed like it. So this is my first one I had. This is my first free arm, bitch. So,
scared.
And as you can see, I mean, people used to, I hate to say this, but people, even white people would
Chad.
He got that chin, he's got those high cheekbones and everything. The man was, yeah, he was, I mean, he wasn't just an athletic superstar, he was a superstar.
Oh, yeah.
Whether you liked sports or not, you knew who OJ was. And you, for some reason, you liked him. Because OJ was a natural in front of the camera. When they put OJ in commercial, now you see actors today, you know, they put, athletes. You see football players. They put them in commercials, they put them in movies, and they say, headline, like this.
There's some infamous footage of some basketball players in a video game who were like, man, I was out there on the court. Why didn't you pass me the ball? You were fucking around.
Yeah, I mean, imagine Michael Jordan, you know, and trying to act with Bugs Bunny.
Hey, what's going on here? Let's play basketball.
You know, it's like, you know what happens when you can't act.
Because they look at the camera and they're all the emotions just going out their face. And all they're saying is moving in their mouth. Because they really try to talk to them with the murder.
I
swear that's how the guy sounds in that video if you find
it. There you go. Yeah. A lot of athletes, needless to say, that big draws, you know, to whatever product they're selling, the big draws, you put them in a movie, but they cannot carry the lines of shit. They can carry a phone, they can't carry a fucking word to save their life. O.J. Simpson. That dude, he was a natural. And you can see these commercials online, but he was the spokesperson for Hertz at the time because he was so good, these commercials, and so charismatic.
Whether it's picking up or dropping off your food or other fine car, nobody has more than go faster.
Run, bitches, run! Fuck the little blonde white girl, y'all better run. Hey, you better not yell at that man. Now, that was a commercial where his ass was running most of the time, so you didn't really get to see him speak a whole lot.
But you could hear him. I was going to say, his delivery was on point with those voiceovers.
You're an actor, right? Yeah, so you need to hear his voice.
Oh, yeah.
And he knew what he was doing.
Oh, yeah, that was top-notch stuff.
So, I mean, the man's name is OJ, so it was only natural that, you know, it was only a matter of time before they put his ass in an Orange Juice commercial.
Obvious.
Yeah, it's way obvious. I mean, you know, if you got the money for OJ, I said, no bring it. You better get his ass up in this commercial. And
then
they get their hands up in your window. Funny thing is, this is some orange juice I don't believe. They're not the kid, man. There's some orange juice I don't think he's around anymore. Like, you would think it's Minute Maid Sunkist or something like that.
Tang
or something. Yeah, you could be Tang.
Yeah.
No, it's some orange juice. I didn't even see the name right now. Some old off-brand orange juice don't even exist anymore, I don't think. Just like OJ. but he talked for a bit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, wow, I can see why this guy went on to be in movies later because he can't act. His delivery's great, his presence from the camera's there, his charisma is just coming through. I mean, the man was made for the camera.
Ready, OJ? Ready.
Right from the tree, right? Yes, sir.
Yeah, right.
cheap sorbet on like crushed up popsicle. And then I'll get discovered because she'd be like, what the fuck, orange juice? She's like, you need that shit again. She's like, why do you have orange right in your mouth? Yeah, man, he was, OJ was, he was great, man.
I'm sure if he had gone to court, Minute Maid would have picked him up and he could have sued him until he died on the bottle of orange juice.
Oh, yeah, he would have been doing, I really believe this, he would have been, killing me. He would have been doing more movies.
And there was a time, I'm sure we're going to talk about it, where he was up for one of the biggest roles of all time.
Yeah, man. No, he would have been in movies, he would have been doing shows, he would have had a podcast, he would have been in commercials, he would have been beloved by people still today. Yeah, if he wasn't, a murderer.
And technically, he still was in the spotlight to some degree. I mean, he was on all types of programs. Sort of. But not by his will, but
some by his will. The thing is, to back this up, you and I were talking about this, you found this out today, and I've been hearing about this back in the day. At one time, OJ was so big a celebrity that he was considered to be the Terminator. This is from 2014, but this is from a long time ago when we talked about this. O.J. Simpson almost played the tournament, and that's from Entertainment Weekly right here. That was news that was going around a lot. Now, of course, he's never played the shit.
He didn't play it in real life, though.
In real life, yeah, he turned in like a motherfucker. But he, that's how huge he was. He was destined to go on and start doing more movies.
I kind of wish that he would have been the Terminator, because then that franchise wouldn't have gone out the way that it did. And the stop those movies.
I mean, it's Terminator. OJ, I'm going to go do this. That shit will still be shit.
Hey, I'll be back with Vitamin C.
Yeah, no, that shit still won't be terrible. That OJ's, hey, his title can only go so far. Also, you were talking about this, I brought this clip up because of you.
Yeah, I mean, when I grew up taking acting classes, they would talk about the physicality of things, and I had multiple acting teachers who would use OJ as an example of someone who really understood physical comedy.
I'm just thinking about this OJ going around killing white people, who would ever probably have to
That
would have been, you would have had to ban those movies, man, with OJ walking around killing, trying to kill white women and white kids, that was
killing white cops.
Not only was this man charismatic and, he played to the screen very well, but he also was a great physical comedian.
Yeah, he knew how to use his body and how to react to things, and that's what acting is, it's reacting. To it, it's really well edited, but he did a lot there.
Listen, that was enough time where he had to, you saw him performing the physical comedy right there.
So I mean,
if you had somebody who didn't have good timing, that wouldn't work.
Oh, no, not at all.
None of this would work. And it went on for a long time, so, the man had charisma, he knew how to read his lines, but he also had comedic timing. Look at what people so. I mean, listen, the main reason why people are hurt by this is because if you believe that OJ killed somebody, then this is horrible, But the thing with him, man, once it did happen, and once he was acquitted, it was hard because him being a hero to people, some of the biggest fans,
even beyond here, he was a sports icon. No if, ands, or buts about it.
Yeah, that's the other thing. The man was a sports icon. He was, a lot of people who are older than me that grew up with OJ, looking at him play, and he played with the Buffalo Bills, and it's just, even the most hardened fans, even the biggest fans, they just, whether you want to admit it or not, you knew he did it. Everybody knew he did it. And that's the thing that people want to use against black people. And they expected black people to stand up and protect OJ. Now, I'll tell you something. There's all kind of people who are standing up and protecting OJ. They don't care what he did. All they want to do is be close to somebody who's famous. jokes about it.
All right.
And yeah, you know, it's kind of, I don't know, some people see that as insensitive as to make jokes, but the jokes dun, dun, were, they were trying to take away from
nothing but a heart attack. Nothing but a heart attack. Yeah.
I didn't kill my wife, but if I did, here's how I do it.
You know, a lot of people out there saying, all right,
and when I make a beach applesauce,
and use comedy,
I make a beach applesauce.
Just let it all out.
I make a beach applesauce.
Nobody wants to say anything. Everybody's tiptoeing
around.
It's going to be
the visitation.
But everybody's going to laugh.
Crook,
at least have a laugh. Knowing that this is a bitch.
That's all, I probably blessed my food already, but I'm blessing again. God is grace. Ooh, God is grace. God is good. Let us thank for this food. God is good. Okay. 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 Okay.
Looking for a treatment option that's right for you? Ask your healthcare provider for more information and visit Entyvio.com. With Entyvio, you may be able to pay as little as $5 per dose. Entyvio.
Elliot, you seem very off edge.
My ex-boyfriend disappeared.
You think you'd all have been supporting the channel by checking out our merch at RejectNationShop.com and becoming Royal Rejects. Real Rejects got invited back to WonderCon. Come geek out with us in person Sunday, March 31st, Reject Nation. Citizens of the Reject Nation, we were bummed we did not get to watch this in the theaters. But right now, myself, Acor711, follow this man on social media, Lord knows he's earned it, and Dat John Humphrey, we are going to watch the greatest comic book movie ever made. And it's us three, so we're going to go in with an open mind. So despite what everyone has said, too excited. Let's man and women on and angry posters! Alrighty, guys.
guys, you know what to do.
Whip that like button. Aha!
Also, subscribe, click that bell, you're notified when we got a reaction out of the channel that piques your interest. Oh, for that ass. Excited?
Yeah, well, has anyone said anything about this movie? I haven't checked it out.
I haven't either. A lot of people have got great views covering it, though, for positively raving about it.
Okay, well, now I'm even more excited.
Yeah, I managed to avoid any and all information about this movie somehow, so, like, this is going to be fresh, and I cannot wait.
Either that means there's nothing exciting, or it's too exciting. You want to preserve the spoilers. Prepper? Thanks for any of Natalie's highlights. And thank you to all of you. Join us at our Patreon page over there. You get the full length reaction watch along for a sync up copy of Madame Web. And we also cover some things over there, exclusive highlights and watch alongs included.
Boys, you're going to meet these chicks?
Let's do it.
Let's see you soon.
Oh, bitch.
Good title card, though.
And the Rudy hands.
Well, what's off about this web?
She's actually filming what will be the opening credits of Spider-Man 2002.
You think we're close?
I love the sound design of the umbrella opening.
I agreed to provide security for you because I thought you were close to finding the spider.
Will it be worth the wait?
Two breakers.
Dead specimens show that the peptides in the spider's venom is...
Damn!
That spider can give super kick.
Any Navi's highlights.
And thank you all for joining us on the Patreon page over there. You get the full length reaction watch along for a sync up copy of Madame Web. And we also cover some of things over there, exclusive highlights and watch alongs included.
Boys, you're gonna meet these chicks.
Let's do it.
Let's see you soon.
Good wish.
Good title card, though.
Yeah.
What's off about this web? She's actually filming what will be the opening credits of Spider-Man 2002.
Still down.
You think we're close?
I love the sound design of the umbrella opening.
I agreed to provide security for you because I thought you were close to finding the spider.
Will it be worth the wait?
Two breakers.
Dead specimens show that the peptides in the spider's venom is...
Damn.
That spider can give superhuman strength and power by Masan.
What spider could do that?
The mythical spider people who run across the treetops and punish evil men with their black poison touch?
What?
I like to base my research on science, not legend.
Science, bitch.
These little spiders have the potential to cure hundreds of diseases.
What a terrible cut!
So you should rest.
Thank you for the umbrella.
Why are you being so rude to this guy?
She's a strong, independent woman.
It's their best hope at surviving when you're 9 months pregnant.
Ooh. What are you doing, my guy?
Research spiders.
I found it! I found a spider!
Oh!
Damn.
What are you doing?
I love these
suits. Yeah. Searching for that spider for years.
I like to base my research on science, not legend.
Science, big.
Well, spider people who run across the treetops and punish evil men with their black poisoning touch?
What?
I like to base my research on science, not legend.
Science, bitch.
These little spiders have the potential to cure hundreds of diseases.
What a terrible cut!
Thank you for the umbrella.
Why are you being so rude to this guy?
She's a strong, independent woman.
It's their best hope at surviving when you're 9 months pregnant.
Ooh. What are you doing, my guy?
Research spiders.
I found it! I found a spider!
Suits.
Yeah.
Searching for that spider for years.
No,
these suits are so
the life scent that lasts.
If you ate bunches of oats, you probably wouldn't have.
No. Give me my CG spider.
The spider people that protect the Amazons.
Already have me on grunting day.
Spider.
Spider healing.
Oh my goodness. The venom of life. Whoa. And a birth.
She will come back. She needs answers. And when she does, I will be here for her.
This is the same place they shot Echo.
Okay, you were born in the Arachna Lazarus pit.
This sounded like a good day to Die Hard.
Now I'm sad I missed that film.
Blockbuster?
Hey!
Might see the boss of the pulse who's carrying more pressures now.
Ben, what are you even doing back there?
Ben? Oh, you want to come take over? I can drive.
So he is Ben Parker. Moves out of the way for ambulances, sir.
Wowie. The amount of cuts, I just feel like I'm watching Taken 3 again.
Never thought it'd be this happy to be back in Queens.
What, you've never been shot out of Queens?
Is he doing one-handed compressions right now?
That's what it's
got to keep his balance.
Yes, get around.
The other character intro.
Lucky from Ghostbusters. Transitions.
Yeah. Whenever I like something, I get worried. I'm gonna like the movie.
I'm glad I caught you before you headed back out. She's gonna be okay. Your patient. Her little boy wanted to say thank you.
Aww. You know what? Mr. Ben Parker here did all the work.
She's so indifferent to saving the lives.
Thank you. That's, yeah. I mean.
Thanks, buddy.
Aww. There's Sydney Sweetie. You see her? Whoa. Where?
I'm her stepdaughter.
I think she might.
Yeah, it's okay, Dad.
She cosplayed as a truck, you know?
Yeah.
She is unrecognizable. It's glasses and over.
You got glasses and a ponytail.
I don't hate family stuff. I think I have plans anyway, so. Well, I like to keep my options open, you know? I might sleep in. I might go to the museum. I might walk the dog.
You don't have a dog.
You need to find a higher purpose.
I don't know what you're talking about. I was a model foster kid. I peed outside and everything.
Shazam. And, that's someone.
What's her name? May?
What's this one's name?
Oh. I may tell you.
Serious.
Her name is June. We know it's May. Parker, just say it,
man.
She's a lucky lady, man.
Thank you.
Just want to tease the audience. It's Gwen Stacy.
See what your future holds for you.
Theme. Wow,
Mr. You will.
Sludge.
Apparently, I have no future.
Cassie, do you know what this means?
What?
It won't come true, you sure?
It means that their print server is broken. We can't eat here anymore.
How are they gonna print my Chinese food? 3D print our dinner. She doesn't care enough to help anyone, except for her job. But, yeah. other women will be your family. Your family.
Hey. So technically, you were born in Peru. You can make this your whole personality.
I can use Peruvian racist words.
I'm Peruvian.
That picture taken the day her mother died, was it the guy who did that?
Yeah, the irony.
No, yeah, this one was really tragic. Did you understand?
Hope the spiders were worth it, Mom.
Stupid spiders.
Talks that box every day.
Wow, it's quick. It's...
Hey, man, it's selling us on the franticness of the situation.
I get it.
Hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
I'm surprised they ain't noticed that it's just this deep.
Spiders.
Talks that box every day.
Wow. It's quick. It's...
Hey, man, it's selling us on the franticness of the situation.
I get it.
Hi, sir.
Hi, sir.
My partner, Ben, is going to help you out on that side of the
day. Wow. First drink, him.
Jeez.
Maybe it was doing it on, maybe it did that on purpose. That's... Who knows?
Strange.
Oh, yeah, I'll bet.
It's an astro projection now.
That's CG air.
Did I die?
Yeah, you went down 3 minutes before I fished you out.
There's only two EMTs in all of New York City.
Too older he looks, and it's what, like 20 or 30 years later?
I need to go to the opera. Pretend to be entertained.
Okay.
Oh, is that for Liz?
Super easy.
Barely. Just look at her.
Greater part of it.
You should see my CGI spider.
Oh, we're about to. There you are. There you go.
She's married.
Whoa. Nice. Nice shot.
Until the end of the movie. Oh.
You're right.
I just felt myself like that.
I just want to go home and watch Idol.
The Idol? Starring The Weeknd? I would prepare auditions while I work like that. He is just 5 seconds ahead in any conversation. Perfect. Always got the beard now. Wow, he hasn't really aged.
I was gonna say, what is he, like, a year or two older he looks, and it's, what, like, 20 or 30 years later?
I need to go to the opera, pretend to be entertained. Oh, is that for Liz?
Super easy.
Barely. Just look better.
Great apartment.
You should see my CGI spider.
Oh, we're about to. There you are, there you go.
She's buried.
Whoa. Nice. Nice shot.
Sonic Garlic Butter Bacon Cheeseburger.
There's a way to cut your dishwashing time by 50%. Try Dawn Power Wash Dish Spray. It removes 99% of grease and grime in half the time. It cleans so well, you can replace multiple cleaning products. Try Dawn Power Wash.
It ain't my dad's razor, Dad.
Hey, watch.
It's from Gillette Labs. This green bar releases trapped hairs from my face.
Game changer.
Well, it flexes this contours to it. And the 5 precision blades finish the job. For the ultimate Gillette shaving experience.
The best thing you catch is Gillette Labs.
At Take 5, you stay in your car because we're faster than you think.
Oil change is done.
I didn't even have time to call and wish my grandma a happy birthday.
For the end of the movie.
Sydney Spiders.
Wow.
It's like watching a dream. Yep. 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 Da 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 da